Mixed Media Girl here. I'm here with the Naughty Artisan and Nick. And this is a countertop that got a little messed up. So we're going to do an acrylic pour on it. And it's going to be a fun like sample board. And then we're going to epoxy it. So
we're going to make this a sweet countertop.
Yeah. Sweetest it's going to be ever. Like basically a really big tree ring.
We're going to put it in a van, I think. It's like a van size one, right?
Yeah. So guys, go ahead. These bottles look the same, but one is blue and one is teal. This one's blue. So I will put all the materials in the description, but basically we're just using various acrylic paints mixed with Floetrol and water. Get started, fill your cup.
That's why I was telling Nick that.
Sheesh,
so
yeah.
Light on the white and the black, right? Or light on the bronze.
Light on the black and the bronze. As much white as you want. Oh, you gotta take the top off. No, because otherwise, I mean, you can do it out that, but you'll get a bunch of air bubbles and stuff in there that you don't necessarily want.
So.
I know, right? We're having a little paint party here. Here, have some purple. Do you want that? Sorry.
It's okay.
There you go. Remember, light on the black, guys. All these paints off, and what we're going to do is we're just going to put a base of white down. And it doesn't have to be particularly thick. This is just going to be to help the paint flow. So we're going to just fill up this guy. Yep, eat it. I'll go ahead and start with one of my cups.
Are we done?
Yeah. I'm going to start here in the corner, pretty much. And we're just going to very slowly, we're doing a tree ring technique here. And we're going to just do one cup at a time. And we're going to tilt after each cup. Gentlemen, let's tilt
like this way, towards this way.
This way, and then this way.
So now we've got the lines, remember, it's not solid all the way through. So we're going to go towards you.
Just straight.
Else one.
We're good. Now back this way a little bit. Okay, good. Now next cup. Bronson. So Bronson, go ahead. And you're basically just gonna pour right in the middle of that, same way I just did.
With this stuff?
Mm-hmm. With your cup.
Just real slow.
Yep.
Uh-huh. I see how it is.
Good. All right. Now we're going to go ahead and tilt. Just tilt this direction.
Okay.
So, Nick, lift up on that end.
Tilt it straight up so it comes straight down.
Yep.
Yep.
There you go. Just do it in the middle there, pretty much. More or less.
That would be the black hole of the galaxy.
Yeah.
Right?
Let me said light, I went less than a third.
Yeah.
Light is subjective.
No tilting yet?
Let's lighten it up just a little.
Good idea.
That's, it's Earth in the galaxy.
Yeah.
That's kind of look cool.
Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and tilt that. So, just with the corners here, it's easiest to just kind of do this.
Layer some stuff in.
Yeah. And then to try to tilt to get everything.
Let me do that.
Okay. And then we'll tilt a bit more to get it all blended in. Okay, guys. So, your job now is to try to get the rest of the cupboard without running all the paint off.
We can do it.
So realize it's pretty heavy in the middle here. So we'll probably want to tilt back this way a bit.
Actually, if we come
and
this way, will
this,
it?
Yeah. Yeah, come this way.
We should see a tree ring over there.
You're so smart. Okay, good. Yep, we got that. So let's tilt it back this way. Some more. Can you imagine doing your kitchen counters like this, guys? Crazy. Crazy talk. I don't feel like it's going to make it.
No? It's pretty
good. Yeah. I think we're good.
What about all this stuff here? Can I, like...
You could if it was clean in the first place, but it wasn't. So you'll just get a bunch of sawdust stuff in there. That's okay. We could actually mix up some more paint real quick if you want.
Something that's maybe just to get the edges.
Yeah, okay.
All right, right here?
Mm-hmm. Good. Okay. I think we're done. I think we got it.
We get that back and level the office.
Yep. Getting it. Okay. Cool. Let's go ahead and do our close-up. So cool. Okay, guys, the countertop is all dry. We are now going to epoxy it. So first things first, we're going to get the epoxy all mixed up. Okay.
Okay, for those of you who don't know,
the stool.
This is 3 ounces per square foot. Got a little diamond dust. It's a little milky. It's because we put air in it when we mixed it.
Yeah.
The air will come out, we'll torch it. It's really warm here too, so it'll help disperse it. We get the pour?
Yeah.
You want to try it or do we want to use our hands?
I use my hands, but you can do whatever you want.
Just make sure we get over those edges nicely.
Yeah. Do you have any chop brushes or no?
I chop with my hands.
Huh.
I do have chop brushes behind you. But the chop is made with our hands.
I like to go in a circular motion.
Oh.
I feel like that mixes it well, plus it ensures I don't miss spots. Somehow. Don't ask me how. It just works.
Oh. I just like to cover all of it. Torch. I'll cart right next to you.
We're going to go ahead and spray some mica powder with some gold on there. Alcohol with gold mica powder. That's kind of exciting.
Yeah.
I think we should torch it right now.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Let's see if it catches on fire.